It's the Joe Padula Show, Clarksville's conversation.
Absolutely.
Eat more of the, eat my tacos. There's a ton of them.
You guys know who the Weeknd is, right? Yeah.
No. I know he's a rapper.
No. He did the Super Bowl, right?
He's such a weird Super Bowl head.
He's a pop singer.
Isn't he
the one that had the surgery?
Yeah.
And okay.
Here, yeah, I saw you know him the Weeknd here. Here,
I saw him on the Super Bowl, but I didn't know who he was previously.
The Weeknd, and you got to spell it wrong.
It's W E E K N D, right?
The Weeknd, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I like this. I like this one. I like the a Blinding Light song. Right, intern Shane.
Oh yeah, this is one of my favorites.
Right, I'm hip.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, start dancing to this. Shame.
Sounds like some old 80s something out of a John out of a John Hughes movie.
That's what I love about this. It's so 80s.
Oh, that's me adding to it.
You know, somebody actually took this song and took a bunch of words said by Donald Trump and mixed it all together with the lyrics.
Yeah, I love those.
It sounds like Trump is singing
those mashups. Yeah, those are great. You know why they're going with this 80s sound too? And I'll tell you exactly why. Stranger Things, the popularity.
80s clothes are coming back, which is terrifying.
If you look at everything, it's a mixture.
Yep.
It's like, okay, they dressed in gangster and street skateboard.
Yeah.
And golf.
Next thing you know, they're going to look like...
Weird.
It goes a lot of different
this
ways.
This song sounds like Aha, like Take On Me.
Kind of, yeah. I never noticed that
the
before.
Beat.
Yeah, it does actually.
The line.
The Trump one video, that's where he's talking about tripping, going down the ramp, right? They made a whole video about him singing about it.
No, it's...
Well, The Weeknd, he's boycotting the Grammys. Rich, do you know why?
I have no idea.
Well, he's saying he's doing it forever.
That's a long time.
Yeah.
Well, not a very long time.
Was he a contender?
Today he said that...
I'm sure the Grammy people are so
sad. Well, he's won 3 Grammys.
Oh, has he?
It's not that many.
It's better than...
It's more than I have.
It's more than I have, that's for sure. Well, he's boycotting.
Boycotting.
I've been watching Peaky Blinders too much.
Yeah.
The boycotting...
Oh, we want to talk about Peaky Blinders?
Because, Thomas Shelby? No. Because of secret committees.
Duh.
That he believes are responsible for selecting nominees. Bay, fill me in, please.
I'm good.
I'm not saying it was the aliens, but...
What do you mean secret committees?
What is the process?
So, TMZ's trash, don't get me wrong, but this is where they're really good at is crap news like this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, they can unearth some details, too.
Well, they say that... there was a growing suspicion that The Weeknd's decision to play the Super Bowl halftime show cost him some Grammy nominations.
Why?
And I don't know.
Why? I mean, you'd think that would be an honor.
Yeah.
Grammy Harvey Mason Jr. said that there was nothing corrupt about Abdel not being nominated. I guess Abdel's his real name?
I have no idea.
Oh. Who's Abdel?
I hope we're still talking about the same story.
Abdel. Alakba. Yeah, so
there's a lot of Abdels. I'm Googling it.
All right,
yes,
so
it's Abel or Abe. It's Abel.
Abel.
Abel Weeknd, the Weeknd, Canadian singer.
Listen, so I'm still Abel. Learning.
Oh, he's Canadian, eh?
Okay.
Most of them are.
So, if he's upset about these secret committees...
Can we talk about maple syrup?
...that are making the nominations for who gets Grammys or not...
It's always been like that.
Well, you have 3 of them, sir. So, obviously, you benefited from this secret committee. And if you don't like it, hand them over.
Right.
Hand them back in.
Yeah, don't if you're going to boycott the Grammys, I agree. You ought to give them back.
Yeah. Weeknd. Hey, good... You want to protest something? Go for it. Give them back.
Sell them on eBay.
I kind of thought all these nominations came from secret committees. Like, what's the actual process for getting nominated for a Grammy?
Yeah.
Like, probably a secret committee. Right?
Do you think he just has sour grapes that he didn't get a nomination this year?
Probably.
Yeah, it's got to be the secret committees.
Again. Bay? Is it sour grapes?
A little bit.
Because how come he didn't say anything when he did get nominated and when he did win?
I gotta say, he
feels slighted by the secret committee, so now he's got to speak out.
His time's probably limited. because I didn't even know this song. I've heard this song.
Yeah.
I did not know it was by him.
Oh, this, yeah, he's got a lot. He's got this other one, Save Your Tears.
It's because it sounds like the B-side from a Toto album.
And I think Save Your Tears is about a song about Chris Brown and Rihanna driving around in a car.
Oh, good Lord. I love The Way You Lie.
Oh, I like the Hills one, yeah.
Driving around in a car, what's it have to do? I know that.
That's why they're canceling. Yeah, that has to do,
yes. Save Your Tears is the name of the song.
Right.
Beating in the car.
Oh, was it in the car? I didn't know it was in the car.
Well, here's the thing.
Just remember, it was all over the text.
Yeah. And wasn't he driving the car?
Yeah, he was driving.
And she started beating him.
Over the
text. People don't talk about this part.
His ex-girlfriend sent him and Rihanna around.
Right. So Rihanna, while this guy's driving, Chris Brown, at high speeds, Rihanna starts pelting him while driving. If I'm driving and someone's beating the poop out of my face, I'm fighting back.
No,
I have
public
to.
Safety. Now,
I had a homeboy that got hit with a 40 bottle across his head while he was driving.
And how did he make it?
He lucky he didn't hit the wall.
Yeah.
It's never good to fight or be punched in a car.
Weeknd, give them back. Get back to Grammys if you're not happy with the Grammys.
Give them back.
Give them back.
Yeah, if you don't give them back, that's like protesting Walmart and then going to Walmart to
right.
get groceries.
Right, and then eating good value ham. Right.
Yeah.
Great value.
Good value.
I got to update my Walmart.
Yeah, the one in Oak Grove level, cutting the it. Good value.
Good value.
Not great value's too much.
It's not great. It's just only good.
It's just one level below great value.
Mediocre value.
So value.
And then you got bad value. Value, which is like
adequate value.
99 cents.
All right, we're dragging the good value joke a little too far.
Can we talk about either Peaky Blinders or maple syrup?
It's the Joe Padula Show.
Bada bing.
Clarksville's conversation.